Hello, I'm Marika Engel, Principal Product Manager for Adobe Analytics. Today I'm going to share a new improved experience for Adobe Analytics Data Warehouse Reporting. Data Warehouse Reporting is a data export option within Adobe Analytics that provides a path to export concatenated reporting tables to a location of your choice. If you need data beyond the limits of Workspace, such as all rows, unique succeeded, or special columns like IP address, Data Warehouse provides a great option. Let's walk through the steps to set up a new scheduled report in Data Warehouse. In this example, I'm going to build a report that contains orders by marketing channel. I've already navigated from Tools to Data Warehouse. Once on the Data Warehouse landing page, I'm going to add a new project, and this kicks off the builder. Across the top of the builder, there are six tabs that represent the steps needed to complete in order to submit your request. I'm going to name my report, and I want to do yesterday's data. So I'm going to do a date range yesterday. And in the first column of the report, I want to see what hour of day it was where the action occurred. So I'm going to select my granularity to be hourly. Moving on to the next tab, I will build my report. Marketing channel, drag and drop that in. Bring in order ID. Order ID instances is a metric. And I want my online orders. And finally, I want to limit this to just US visitors. So I've created a segment that does just that. I'm going to drop that into the segment area. Now my report is looking pretty good. I'm ready to go on to the next stage. In report destinations, you're going to set up and define your account and your location. An account is your credentials for a specific destination, and the location is the folder in which you're going to drop the data. I'll look at both email and S3 quickly just to show you the options. When you select your S3, if you've set up an S3 account, in here you'll set up your account name, your role ARN, your security options. And then when you add a location, you can add the location name, and the prefix will be again the folder within the bucket. You can add your location. This is looking good, so I've got my account and my location. Now I'm going to go to report options. In this tab, you can select additional details, what the format of the report is, whether you're returning all rows or you only want the first million rows, for instance, and other additional options. In the next tab, you'll decide whether you want to send it right now as a one-time report or set it up as a schedule. I'm going to set it up as a schedule. And since this was yesterday's data, I want to get it daily, every day, starting today and ending 1 year from now. And finally, the last step, because I'm using a cloud destination, is that I'd like to receive an email when the report delivers. So I'm going to add my email address, and I could set it to be marketing channel orders delivered. And once I'm happy with this, I can click Save Request, and it will set up and schedule that report to run daily. So going back to report destinations, I just want to also touch on email. Can add an account, such as your email, or you can select a new email. I'm just going to set up a new one here. When you add a new account, you select the account type. Here I'm going to select email, marketing channels, and give it a description, email for marketing channels. And this is where I would add my list of recipients. This then adds the account and selects it as the option. Then I'd still need to add a location, even for email. And the location, this will be my marketing channel email location. and the description is. And this sets the subject for the email. So I want to make this really specific. Once I've done that, I can add my location for email. And notice that the notification email is now grayed out because this is not a cloud destination, and so I do not need to receive a separate email. Once I'm happy with my email setup and I've set up my report and everything, I can again save the request. Then when I come back into Data Warehouse later, I'll be able to see the status of this ongoing scheduled report. This was a brief overview of the new Data Warehouse UI for Adobe Analytics.